Avenue is named after the iconic Fifth Avenue in New York City. But now the luxury retailer is heading east, far east. Allison Kosick of the New York Stock Exchange with the details. Now, this was a little bit of a surprising location for Saks.
It is, and you know, I'm thinking that you may be thinking Kazakhstan, people think of Borat. Well, now I think you should think about luxury when you think of Kazakhstan, because Saks Fifth Avenue is opening its first store in Kazakhstan next year. It looks like in the summer of next year. This is going to be part of a
get for these kinds of high-end stores in Kazakhstan.
Actually, there is. You know what? If you ask Saks, they'll tell you Kazakhstan's affluent population is really growing. The country's doing really well. It's got low unemployment at 5.5% compared to our 9% unemployment rate. It's growing at a 7% pace compared to our 2% pace. And as for the purchasing power of the people of Kazakhstan, the GDP per capita is $12,000. You know what? It's pretty good. It's comparable to Mexico. And the reason that Kazakhstan is growing so well is because of its growing oil and gas industry. Kira.
All right, Allison, thanks.
Well, the housing market is actually showing signs of life, with home prices increasing now for the first time in 8 months in April. Now, that's according to the latest S&P Case-Shiller Index. But with many homeowners underwater on their mortgage, there's some folks who just can't wait to sell and are simply walking away. Allison Kosick is here with today's top tips on those who are actually defaulting on their homes on purpose. Allison, is that ever a good idea?
You know what, it's not really the best option, but sometimes, you know, these homeowners have no choice, Suzanne. You know, lots of homeowners, they're strapped for cash. They may be thinking, you know what, I'm just going to walk away from my home because I'm thinking it's a good option. And what's this really called? It's called a strategic default. It's basically when a homeowner chooses not to pay their mortgage and goes into foreclosure on purpose. And experience says, you know what, this is still pretty popular for people to do. It's accounting for about 17% of all defaults in the second quarter of last year. But as you mentioned, there are downsides, big downsides to walking away. So Carmen Wong Ulrich, she's the author of The Real Cost of Living. She's got a few tips if you're planning to foreclose as part of a financial strategy. First, she says take a look at all of your mortgage modification options. Talk with your lender. And if there's another option before you walk, if you have another place to live, consider renting out your home to cover costs while offering it for a short sale.
Suzanne. Now, Allison, wouldn't that impact your credit in some way? I mean, couldn't that really destroy your credit?
It really could. You know, and John Oldheimer of smartcredit.com, he gives the harsh realities of this. He says you really should remember that walking away from your home is reported as a foreclosure or deed in lieu of foreclosure, depending on how you left it with your lender. And either one of those will hit, Suzanne.
Wow, that is a heavy price to pay. Allison, I want you to stay with us because I want to ask you about the emotional toil that this must take if you actually are faced with foreclosing your home and you have to make that kind of decision. We're going to have more on that just ahead.